Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll discuss some tips and tricks to help minimize inefficient searches in Splunk. Search optimization is a technique for making your search run as efficiently as possible. When we do not optimize our searches, they take more time to complete, retrieve larger amounts of data from the indexes than is needed, and inefficiently use more memory and network resources. Then if we multiply these issues by hundreds or even thousands of searches, the end result is a slow or lagging system. The first method we can use to tackle inefficient searches is limiting the data we are retrieving from disk. Time is the most efficient filter in Splunk. The less data you have to search, the faster Splunk will be. The time range picker has preset time ranges, relative, real time, and even custom time ranges, so you can really narrow down to just what you need. Alternatively, you can specify absolute and relative time ranges using the time modifiers of earliest and latest. Time modifiers used in a search will override what is selected in the time range picker. After time, the default fields of index, source, host, and source type are the most powerful. These fields are extracted at index time, so they will not need to be extracted for each search. Another way of increasing search efficiency is to simply be as specific as possible. It's better to search for failed password instead of just password. Inclusion is generally better than exclusion, as more resources are used tracking not expressions than if you specify what you are looking for. Wildcards at the beginning or middle of a string may cause Splunk to search through an unnecessary amount of information, so use them at the end of the string only when necessary. Instead of wildcards, try using the or in operators. We can also limit the amount of results returned by using event sampling. Other limiting commands, such as head or top, can be used to further reduce the amount of data returned. Extracting fields from events can be costly on resources, so reducing the amount of fields retrieved can be a very effective approach. The fields command can be used to tell Splunk exactly which fields you want to work with. All we have to do is write our search, pipe to fields, and write out the fields we want. Comparing the results, we see the search time is reduced significantly. Another way of limiting the fields returned is altering our search mode. There are three search modes to choose from: fast, smart, and verbose. Fast mode prioritizes speed over completeness. Field discovery is disabled for this mode, only returning information on default fields and fields required to fulfill your search. Verbose mode prioritizes completeness over speed, returning all extracted fields, an event list, and an event timeline for every search. Due to the increased size of search payload, verbose mode is the slowest search mode option. Smart mode is the default search mode, balancing speed and completeness. If a transforming search is run, it will behave like fast mode. If a non-transforming search is run, it behaves like verbose mode. There is also a lot of opportunity to optimize beyond the search terms, like postponing non-streaming commands until later on in the pipeline. Streaming commands can be executed at the indexer level, whereas non-streaming commands must be executed at the search head, as they need to be run on all events returned from any indexer responding to the search. Apply filtering commands, like where or search, as early as possible in the search pipeline. Filtering early limits the number of events returned, making future manipulations of the data faster. Once you've filtered down to just the data you need, you can start introducing calculating commands, like eval or field format, to manipulate or format the data. Lastly, it's important to remember there are lots of searches that are running across the environment, not just ad hoc searches. Splunk allows you to create summaries of your event data. These are smaller segments of event data populated by background searches that only include the data needed to fulfill the search. When you run a search against one of these summaries, it should complete significantly faster, since the data you are searching over is much smaller than the original raw events. Splunk has three data summary creation methods: report acceleration, summary indexing, and data model acceleration. Report acceleration will use automatically created summaries to speed up completion times for certain kinds of reports. Summary indexing enables search acceleration through the manual creation of summary indexes. Data model acceleration will accelerate all fields defined in a data model. Data model acceleration is the easiest and most efficient method and will typically be your first choice. On dashboards, any visualizations that are driven by saved searches or data models are likely to benefit from acceleration. This allows Splunk to run searches against the accelerated summaries of data, rather than having to search through the raw data. We recommend using scheduled reports where possible instead of inline searches, in order to prevent a flood of search jobs when dashboards are loaded. Thanks for joining us to learn more about writing efficient searches in Splunk. To continue your journey learning about Splunk, we suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.